describes government ties as a, quote, one big happy family vibe. Ohio Congressman Brad Wenstrup joins us now. Congressman, thanks for being here. So here's one of the tweets from Matt Taibbi as well, and then we got to get your general reaction. He said, between January 2020 and November of 2022, there were 150 emails between the FBI and former Twitter officials. And it goes on to describe the coziness of that relationship. That was between the FBI and former Twitter Trust and Safety Chief Yoel Roth. How concerned are you about the depth of the connection here?
I'm very concerned because not only is this seemingly extremely inappropriate, it comes across as nefarious, very political, and very much with political bias. You know, the trust in our agencies, the FBI and intelligence community, is certainly waning, even amongst politicians, and to some degree on the other side of the aisle. You know, I grew up watching a show called FBI where they went out and caught criminals. Now it seems like they're more interested in hunting down opinions or even facts that they don't seem to like. But the laundry list goes on and on, Pete. You know, the inspector general had shown how the FBI abused the FISA court. We saw how the FBI aided and abetted the false Russian narrative, Russian collusion narrative. We saw when a director of FBI, acting director McCabe, was in charge, when a guy tried to assassinate us at the baseball field, clearly trying to kill Republicans. They called it suicide by cop. Well, you don't get suicide by cop by trying to shoot down a non-policeman like Steve Scalise. You know, we see them say that the Hunter Biden's laptop was misinformation. And clearly it wasn't. And we know that now. It just goes on and on. And now we get into the origins of COVID, and we can't trust the intelligence community on that because they are stonewalling us. They don't answer our questions, and they are certainly ignoring certain facts.
No doubt about that. And this is just one aspect of what we were allowed to see inside Twitter. It's likely more than 80 agents if they're working with other social media companies like Meta, Google. So this is just the tip of the iceberg. A lot more to be found. Thank goodness Twitter's talking about it, and hopefully hearings will be held about it. But there's another aspect of what you mentioned, COVID-19 and right. the information suppression there. House Republicans are now alleging that not only did it emerge from China and out of a lab, but it was potentially part of a bioweapons program. Now, you speak as someone with authority on this. You're a colonel in Army Reserve, Iraq War vet. What are the chances that this is not just escaped from a lab, but was part of a Chinese biological weapons program?
Yeah, you know, not that I'm a physician and serve on the Intelligence Committee, right? And what we've come out with so far with our report is just the beginning. The intelligence community came out and said that they had broad agreement that this was COVID-19 was not developed as a bioweapon. Yet they gave us no level of confidence in that assessment. They didn't tell us who made the assessment, and they didn't give us the basis for their assessment. And that's totally diverging from what an intelligence report should give us. They don't report on safety issues at the lab. They don't talk about the Academy of Military Medical Science that the Chinese have and the Fifth Institute that's underneath that, that works with the Wuhan Institute of Virology. And they work on coronaviruses and bioweapons. Our own State Department, going back to 2005, has talked about how the Chinese want to develop offensive bioweapons. And even in 2015, they published a book that talked about human viruses as genetic weapons. You know, we know the capability is there. In 2015 also, Ralph Barrick in North Carolina created a chimera or gain-of-function type of virus with Xi Zhengli of China. So why are we doing this? Where is information on why we're giving grants to NIH, which then funds EcoHealth Alliance, doing work in China's labs?
As your report indicates, we conclude that there are indications that COVID may have been tied to China's biological weapons research program and spilled over to the human population during a lab-related incident. Yet intelligence agencies say, we'll give you no proof, but the consensus is it didn't come from a lab. It's how many times can they lie to our face and then provide no evidence? Representative Brad Wenstrup, thanks for getting to the bottom of this. We appreciate it.
We'll keep digging.
You got it.
We'll keep digging.
Thank you.